What is going on, guys? So my immediate morning routine right when I wake up is typically what you just saw. I'll get up, weigh myself, brush my teeth, wash my face, all that good stuff, come immediately into the kitchen, and I will have my coffee. While I'm having my coffee, I will take my supplements. I'm just gonna briefly show you guys the supplements that I use. I'm not gonna get super in depth with them, just give you guys a little background on why I use them. So first thing is I have grass-fed, grass-finished, organic beef liver. Now guys, this is filled with so many nutrients, vitamins, minerals, all of that good stuff, that I use this over a multivitamin, and I recommend you guys do the same thing if you're looking to get good quality nutrients, vitamins, minerals in the morning, every single day. So yeah, I use that. And then another thing I use is vitamin D3. I take 10,000 IUs a day. So the reason why I take this is for my immune system and also my gut health as well. Vitamin D is actually really, really good for promoting gut health. Turmeric, great for just overall inflammation of the body. Turmeric. Says right here, supports healthy inflammation response. But yeah, that's why I use my turmeric. You take fish oil, great for your heart, your arteries, your blood pressure, those good things. I use potassium and magnesium as well, especially because I do a lot of fasting. Typically on a daily basis, I fast for 16 hours and then I eat over an 8-hour window. So it's kind of like a 16-8 intermittent fasting schedule. And then actually every single Sunday I do a 24-hour fast. So not necessarily recommending it for everybody. However, for me, it works incredibly well for keeping my appetite under control, being able to stay super shredded, and overall just having a lot of energy throughout the day, not feeling lethargic from eating too many times throughout the day or just overall too much. And I eat really high quality food, so it gives me the nutrients and the energy that I need in the two meals that I do eat. So I only eat two meals a day. And I am gonna show you guys those two meals that I am gonna eat today, but that's gonna be a little bit later. Anyways, that's just a little background on what I do, kind of why I do it. I have looked into a lot of the research on fasting. Many people are against fasting. I wouldn't recommend doing like 16 hours plus fasting frequently if you're trying to bodybuild, powerlift, and get bigger, stronger. My goal is to maintain my muscle, you know, grow slowly over the years, very slowly, but more so maintain and keep a very lean, athletic, good cardio physique, essentially. So that is kind of where I'm at, but I use these to help me with my fasting, feel good while I fast. Potassium and magnesium help balance electrolytes, help you feel good while you're fasting. If you guys do want to try fasting, the one thing I want to say is go into it very slowly. Start out with like 12 hours. If you like it, you know, maybe bump it up a little bit, but it's not for everybody. Most people will benefit from it. However, if you're a bodybuilder, powerlifter, again, I would not recommend going over 12 hours just because it's not gonna be the most optimal for muscle mass, gaining, etc. Now, not to say you cannot still get great results doing fasting 16 hours, 18 hours. I'm just saying, you know, if your number one sole goal is get bigger, get stronger, you know, maintain muscle, whatever it might be if you're cutting, then I probably wouldn't do, you know, like I said, over 12 hours, but that's just me. Anyways, right now I am gonna go get onto my computer, show you guys my workstation that I'm gonna be at for the next probably 6.5 hours, doing my client check-ins, which is what I do every single Monday through Friday. For between like 5 to 8 hours, Monday through Friday, I work on all my client stuff, which I absolutely love. It's like solving a riddle. I have, you know, so many different people with so many different goals. Everybody is so different. So, you know, just solving the puzzle, helping each specific person, I really, really enjoy, and I get to do it from the comfort of my home. So let's go see where I do my work. My hair is a fuck show, but this right here is where the magic is done, folks. So yeah, pretty much every single day I sit here at my computer. I have like my big desk right here in my apartment. So this is my apartment right here. Nice and clean, actually. And then we have another bedroom. That's our bedroom. But this is like my desk. My girlfriend kind of uses the office room in there. But basically, guys, what I do almost every single day is what I just told you, okay? I'm on my computer doing client work. I'm bringing new clients on, working on future businesses, that I'm not gonna even speak about right now. But yeah, this is kind of what I do on a daily basis, and one of the reasons I haven't been filming vlogs all the time. But my content will be a lot of informational content, like you guys saw in my last video, the steroid topic video. I have another video coming out next week. And then also, I am gonna start filming vlogs as well here and there. Not, you know, 3 times a week, but maybe once a week, once every 2 weeks, and then I'm gonna trickle in to make sure I hit my 1 video a week minimum, the informational content. But that's why I have not been filming like I used to, is because nowadays my life is just much different. You know, I'm building my business. I am, you know, busy all day working on my computer. And then after that, I mean, I like to go take a walk, get fresh air, I go train, all that good stuff. So I'll just bring you through the day. But anyways, this is what we're gonna be doing for the next few hours. And then I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna be eating for my meal number one today out of two. And yeah, that'll be fun. So I'll see you guys in the next few hours. All right, so we are here for meal one right now. I'm gonna show you guys everything that I have. The number one thing I was gonna say is what you're gonna notice is this is extremely low carb. This meal right here, now not every single day do I do super low carb. Some days I'll do a shit ton of like sweet potato, black rice, really good quality complex carbs. Today I just happen to be doing a low carb day. I do enjoy doing it. If I need carbs, I know my body, I'll eat them, but I do feel really good most days doing extremely low carb. Now, not recommending it for everyone, this is just what I do, guys. And again, I don't do this every single day. So, first off, where do I start? Okay, we have a lot. So, I have 6 pasture-raised organic eggs. I have a bunch of pieces of bacon. This is organic pasture-raised local bacon from Colorado. I would never eat bacon unless it was pasture-raised organic bacon where I knew exactly where it was coming from. I know the lady who owns the farm. We have raspberries right here. Primal Kitchen sugar-free ketchup for the eggs. Little concoction of beets, organic, and then also organic pitted green olives. Now I have this Primal Kitchen's sesame ginger dressing. This is based with avocado oil, no seed oils, all organic ingredients, high quality healthy dressing. We have the mix right here of, I believe, arugula, spinach, and arugula and spinach is what that is in there. And then I have this local Colorado, Royal Colorado honey. Now, what this is, royal jelly with propolis and added bee pollen. This is extremely good for immune system and gut health. Very, very good stuff. 2 tablespoons of that. And then also over here, I have a really good brand, Kettle and Fire, turmeric ginger bone broth. Now, usually I would do a grass-fed, grass-finished beef bone broth from this brand. However, I decided today I had the chicken, so I'm gonna do the chicken one. Now I'm gonna enjoy this meal right now, guys. It looks fucking awesome. I've been fasting like 16 and a half hours, so I'm a little bit hungry. I usually don't get super hungry anymore just because of how my diet is. I don't really get all that hunger anymore doing 2 meals a day, the 16-8, high fat, high good quality foods. Again, I just don't really get starving. Haven't eaten since last night at like 7, and right now it is, I don't know, it's been about 16 and a half, 17 hours. Anyway, I'm gonna enjoy the food right now, and then I will talk to you guys after the meal. Just crushed that meal down right now, and I'm about to get some more work done before I head over to the gym, which is the next thing that I'm actually gonna be filming. Gonna film my pull day today, which should be a lot of fun, show you guys kinda how I'm currently training. But what I also wanted to say is, you know, like with the grabby thumb or title, thumbnail, whatever, being how I stay shredded, all that good stuff. I just wanna be very clear. You can get shredded, stay shredded, eating, you know, multiple meals throughout the day, having carbs in your diet every single day, like high carb, normal, you know, moderate carb, whatever you want to say. The thing is, okay, there's many different ways to do it. The way that I do it allows me to actually enjoy my diet, not be hungry, and stay shredded. Okay, so there are benefits to intermittent fasting for fat loss. However, like I stated, I just want to be very clear, you can do it without intermittent fasting as well.
Just the thing is, when you're eating simple carbs throughout the day, when you're doing like a typical bodybuilding diet, eating like white rice and rice cakes and all those things, you're gonna be hungrier. Now, is it better for bodybuilding? Probably yes. But you're gonna be hungrier throughout the day. It's gonna be more miserable trying to stay at like a body fat that I'm at right now, at least for me, and also for a lot of my clients I've noticed as well.
All right, fam, so we are back in Big Bertha, my truck, if you guys know what I'm talking about. It's been a minute since we've had a little truck talk, but I'm about to head in the gym right now, and I just wanted to say I'm gonna pop up the workout that I'm about to do on the next screen after I'm done talking right now, and so you guys can follow the workout, try it for yourselves. Now, the thing with this workout that you're gonna wanna focus on is very high intensity. This is a high intensity, hypertrophy focused, detail focused workout. So this is not, I'm not going to do deadlifts. I'm gonna be doing, my first exercise is gonna be either a chin-up or a pull-up, and then I'm gonna get into it. It's gonna be a very good, solid back workout, but there's just not gonna be deadlifts, rack pulls, anything like that. So the goal here is to focus on 45 seconds to 1 minute rest for all of the movements, and to get a disgusting pump, really break the muscle down, and get out. So this workout will probably take me 45 minutes, I don't know, maybe an hour, something along those lines. After the workout, I'm gonna do 20 minutes of cardio on the stairs, and I'm gonna do level 10 for 18 minutes. The last 2 minutes, I'm gonna bump it up to like 20. So super high intensity stairs after the workout to get my heart working, burn some calories, get a sweat going, and yeah, that's kind of what I'm gonna do. It's funny because I don't really sweat during my workouts nowadays because of all the athletic training I do. It's like the workouts that I do just, I don't know, they're not, like weight training is not that hard to me now, like cardio wise. So I don't know, like I don't really feel like I break a sweat until I like fucking slam myself in the Stairmaster. Not to say I don't sweat when I train, or training's not easy, but just compared to like running 3 miles straight or boxing for an hour, it's, I mean, in my opinion, it is easier. But anyway, or I don't know, maybe the same, but definitely easier on your cardiovascular. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna go in there and do this. So keep that in mind with the workout, 45 seconds to 1 minute rest. If you guys have any questions down below about workout stuff, drop it below and I'll try to answer some questions when I'm getting back to comments. Also, I wanted to address something in my last video, which actually kind of took off. It's probably gonna have 100,000 views by the time you guys watch this. I said, oh, you know, I'm not taking steroids anymore, I'm taking TRT, right? So number one, okay, I did not mean it like trying to say, hey guys, I'm natural now, I'm natural, I'm natty. I could give a fuck less if people think I'm natty or not natty, or they know that I'm not natural. I'm not trying to claim natural by saying I'm on TRT. My point is that I'm no longer gonna blast steroid cycles. I am taking tests, I'm not natural. So just to be very clear, I'm aware that I'm not fucking natural. You trolls, bunch of damn trolls on the internet. But anyway, just clearing that up. I'm not natural, I'm just taking a low amount of test, and I enjoy it, that's why I do it, and I do it as healthy as I can do it. I was watching some old fucking Island Gym videos last night on my channel, Dave's channel. I just went on a nostalgic binge. If you guys were here when the Purple Island Gym days were in session with Dave and I, you guys know what I'm talking about if you used to watch the Purple Island Gym days, comment below, let me know, fucking OG. I miss those days sometimes. It's crazy to think that I've been training for, not training, sorry, I've been filming videos, me and Dave have been doing content for like 7 fucking years now. 6.5, 7 years, something like that. It's just insane. Like the first videos happened with Dave and I, like I think 7 years ago. Fuck, man. So much has changed, but I'll never forget my roots. I promise you that. Anyway, I'm gonna shut the fuck up and I'm gonna go in the gym. Enjoy this workout. Try it. It's gonna be good. Make sure you do the rest times. Don't be a little bitch. And yeah, I'm signing off. I'll see you guys after the workout to show you guys my second meal of the day before we sign the video off. All right, peace. Breathe in, breathe out.
My daily meditation.
Breathe in, breathe out.
Help me when I'm escaping.
Breathe in, breathe out.
You're keeping me from fainting.
Breathe in, breathe out.
Go put that money in that. My brown paper bag, know your love's gonna last.
My scribble notes are your tats on your front and your back. I don't even need a notebook. Oh, Robin Steele, everything you conceal. All the ghosts from my past get a toast and I laugh as I choke on his gas. Oh yeah, oh yeah, yeah. I lack, then I jam on my MacBook. Had a panic attack, thought I was gonna yak, but you still got my back, though. You can fold, take you everywhere that I go. When I'm drunk, talking shit, you don't judge, you don't trip.
What's going on, guys? So I am randomly ending the video in my closet because my girlfriend has a friend over and I don't want to film out there because it's awkward. Same reason why I just filmed the food that you guys just saw. But what I'm going to do is read to you what all three of those meals were exactly. Now, I don't know what my exact macros are for the day. I just kind of intuitively eat and just eat good quality food, and it keeps you boy peeled. So we have like a little bit of, it's like a meal prep service that we get food from every few weeks. So that's what we had. That's what I had tonight, was three of those meals. Obviously I need three of them because I only eat twice a day. I still need to get my cows in. So I had grilled sustainable salmon with quinoa, seasonal veggies, and then a cilantro pumpkin seed pesto. All of that is dairy free, super high quality ingredients. And that goes for all the dishes as well. The next one with the salad was butternut squash, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, kalini bean, organic kale, grass-fed mulberry, pomegranate, horseradish, vinaigrette. And the last one was miso, sesame glaze, sweet potato, turmeric, charred onion, snap pea, portobello, avocado, hemp seed, and then that cilantro pumpkin seed pesto again. So, and that dish is actually vegan. So that's what I had for dinner. That was my meal number two. My calories during the week are about 2,400. And then, so Monday through Friday, and then every Saturday I have about 5,000-6,000 calories of good quality food, but I need it as a refeed. So I do the lower calories during the week. I just feel sharper. I have better energy when I do that and I enjoy it more, so I do it. And then on the week, and then yeah, every Saturday I do a higher day, which is about 5,000-6,000 calories of good quality food again, but I just increase it so that I can maintain a certain size, because I'm about 181 to 184 in the morning is what I weigh at any given time. Closer to 181, 182 now. So yeah, I don't want to fucking wither away, guys. But anyway, on Sundays, I also do a 24-hour fast. So, and then I eat one big, nutritious, quality meal every Sunday. So that's kind of my normal-ish routine lately. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys want to see more vlogs or whatever you guys want to see more of, let me know down below. And I'm going to be making more videos. I have a new video going live next week as well. Like I already have it filmed and everything like that. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Jeez, Grayson.